Folks, it's a Sunday showdown. We've got all kinds of trivia. We're talking hit streaks and walk-offs. Let's step up to the plate. Adam, cue the walk-up music. Hey, everyone. Thanks for joining us today. We're still celebrating 100 subscribers. It's a big deal for us. We love having y'all join us. We're diving into it again today. Coffee. Trivia, and it's action-packed today. We're going to see who ends up winning this week. We're tied at two. We're going to see who takes a little bit of a lead here. So, Adam, what's our trivia for today?
Diving right into the late innings here. Orlando Arcia has not gone hitless more than two straight games this year. What is his longest streak in 2023? So this is inspired by Arcia, who's getting hits, and the Braves Nation is wondering, is he that guy? Is he the shortstop of our future?
Mm-hmm.
To be determined, I suppose, but we're not answering that question today. We're answering this one. What is Arcia's longest hit streak this season? 4, 6, 9, or 11 games. Aaron, what do you got?
Well, I figured if he's hitting that in that many games, you got to string some together. So I went 11. It's not a huge hit streak. So that's what I went with here, 11.
And I went with 9. This guy hasn't popped up on my hit streak radar this year, So it's keeping it pretty modest here.
Yeah.
But let's go to the stats and see what we got. The correct answer is actually only 6.
6.
Well, only 6. So,
yeah.
You know,
there you go.
It's not too streaky, I guess, just the appropriate amount of streaky. Yeah. So let's take a peek at the scoreboard, see where we're at. After the 7th, we're still tied at 4 heading into the 8th and 9th. Well, let's not keep everyone, you know, in on the edge of their seats too long.
Yeah,
let's just go right into it here. So,
what can happen?
Throw my first pitch at you here in the 8th inning, and it is. So this one's a little bit of a different one. So there are 5 possible options. I'm going to use my random number generator. To determine how many you have to get out of the 5.
Okay.
All right. So there are 5 players under 25 who have at least 10 homers and 10 stolen bases.
Okay.
If you do, use my number generator. Oh, disappointing for me. You only need to get one of them.
Well, yeah, I'm going to go with your boy Corbin Carroll here. He'd also be joined by Acuna and Julio. I don't know who the other two are, though.
Bobby Witt Jr. and Josh Lowe are the others.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
All right.
Got your point there. All right. Let's see how I can do here in the 8th.
All right, Adam. We're coming late innings, so we got a little walk-off topic question here. In New York, a high school team recently won a state championship in truly obscure fashion. When they won on a walk-off, what?
I saw this one. It's going everywhere. Going bonkers. On a walk-off dropped third strike.
Yes, which was incredible. But if you haven't seen it, folks, you got to go look it up and watch it. It's bonkers. They get a strikeout. I don't know if they thought they tagged him or what. Team celebrating. And meanwhile, the runner round circles the bases. They're both wearing red. It's pandemonium and chaos.
the both wearing red was what struck out to me right away. Yeah, I was like, who planned this one?
Yeah.
But anyway, so here we are. We're heading into the 9th tied game.
Okay.
It is tense. So here we go. I'm throwing you my next question here. So Jose Ramirez recently had a 3-homer game. He hit a home run in his first 3 at-bats. How many more hits did he get the rest of the game?
He got 0 hits the rest of the game.
That is correct. That's correct.
So,
okay. So it's the 9th inning. So you get I got to throw you another trivia pitch here. So Phillies manager Rob Thompson was recently ejected. After arguing with an umpire about a pitch clock situation, in particular, the pitch clock didn't reset. What was the argument about?
So I feel like a lot of these are like switching balls out, but I feel like everybody should know that by now. So I'm just going to say that the pitcher disengaged but didn't throw over, like stepped off but didn't throw over, and it didn't reset for whatever reason. That's my guess.
You should have stuck with the first one. The first one was correct because Aaron Nola was pitching and he kept throwing out balls, and the umpire was ruling that he was using it to circumvent the pitch clock.
Yeah, I tried to get cute and cost.
You did. You did. Okay. But you got one. So, heading to the bottom here, and I'm down a run. I'm nervous.
I feel really good about my question here coming up, by the way. I feel great. Okay. So, here's the question. There is a fella. His name is Jimmy Jensen. And I'm guessing you don't know who Jimmy Jensen is.
My first thought was, oh, no.
All right, so Jimmy Jensen was cut from his high school team, played club baseball in college, never played professionally in the U.S., but has played professionally baseball for how many different countries?
Okay, I have no clue here, and I'm just going to throw a number at the wall here and see what we get. I'm going to go with lucky number 7.
7 is correct. Correct. Oh, it's unbelievable. It's like you just drilled an 2 out bottom of the ninth 0-2 slider, hit it for a game-tying home run. That's what that you
used to do. Or I tied the game on a wild pitch or something.
Yeah, on a drop third strike.
Drop third strike, exactly. Okay, all right. So we got a tie game. Yep. You got to keep throwing to me because it's the ninth, and I got one right. So I got a chance to walk it off here.
Okay, so in line with that, I have another walk-off question for you.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so recently the White Sox walked off the Tigers on a wild pitch. But this was no like ordinary between the catcher's legs wild pitch. This one was a little bit wacky. Why was it a little bit unusual?
Oh, I know this one. I'm going to walk it off. The wild pitch, a pitcher and the catcher were not on the same page, and the ball hit the umpire right in the face, bounced off, and the runner on third scored.
Yeah. I mean, it was a direct hit with a 96 mile an hour fastball.
Yeah.
It's like the umpire didn't hardly flinch, and everybody's like coming out like, is this guy going to live? Or It was quite well. Adam, congratulations. Walked it off and dropped 3 straight now.
So. Yeah. Well, I've won 3 straight, including a couple of walk-offs in a row here. Out of the 5 games we've played, 4 have ended in walk-offs.
I know. Are we the
bonkers?
Maybe people are starting to think that maybe we're rigging this system.
Yeah. Well, we assure you that we're not.
Yeah, we're not. Yeah.
But, so. Come back next week when I blow out Aaron. just trash talking a little bit. Well, story time. Yeah. I get my story time here.
Yeah, let's do it.
It's story time, folks. I get my story time. And speaking of international baseball and 7 countries, I have not played baseball in 7 countries. I have not played professional baseball in any countries, but I have played baseball either on a team or casually in 3 different countries. The 2 countries I've played on a team were the U.S. and South Korea. And the one country I played sort of like this pickup baseball game in Japan when I was in college. And it was this funny game that these sandlot baseball game that these guys taught me and another friend. It was 2-on-2. And these college guys taught us this game. You use a rubber ball that's the size of a baseball, and the pitcher stands about the same distance from like second to home instead of pitcher to home, and they throw the ball, and the pitcher has to make it bounce at least once but not more than twice, and then the batter hits the ball. and you get single, double, triple, whatever, based on does the ball hit the fence in the air? Does it bounce to the fence? Does it whatever?
Yeah, interesting.
And so we played this game for hours with these guys, had a blast, and the game ended when I was batting, and I hit the ball out of the field, so we couldn't play anymore.
Well, this is like a sandlot style.
It's like a sandlot style, so we had to end the game because the ball was gone. And at the end, they called me Mark McGuire because at the time he was the big white home run hitting player in Major League Baseball. So
that's funny because I was in Japan, obviously, the same time that you were. And my buddy Drew and I got invited to play baseball with some guys, more of like a pickup game, but with many more than four people. And I was they also call me Mark McGuire. This is not the same people, by the way. They also call me Mark McGuire. I did not hit a big long home run. I did hit an inside the park home run, ground ball down the third baseline, and I circled the bases.
That's usually how it goes, huh?
That's how it goes. Yeah. Yeah. And I actually have played in four different countries. So on a team.
Between us, we've matched Jimmy Jansen.
Yeah, but not, you know, different. We overlap. The only country I can add in there is Slovenia. Did some practice with a wood bat team there. Their name was the Gloves.
The Gloves, that's a great name.
Yeah. And in Slovene it's Golovec.
Yeah.
So there you go.
All right. Well, that wraps up story time and our
thanks, everybody,
on the showdown
for joining us. Thanks to MLB Stathead and Baseball Reference for this fun data that we got to put together. If you got a burning question, drop it in the comments below. Find us on Twitter, tweet at us there. We love hearing your comments, your feedback, your ideas for questions. All that kind of stuff is fun for us to do. Please like, subscribe, share with your friends. We're back at it tomorrow for a new game and a new week. See you, folks.